After arriving in Casablanca, I spent the day exploring the Medina and also visited the Hassan II Mosque, the seventh largest in the world. After preparing the bark and shopping for some provisions, it was time to leave the city and begin my journey inland towards the Atlas Mountains. The terrain was far more lush than what I was expecting. The region between the coast and the mountains is mainly agricultural and mining. Morocco holds 75% of the world's phosphate reserves. The temperatures here reached close to 40 degrees C, but ahead of me in the mountains, I could see snow visible on the peaks. Deep in the Atlas Mountains, and the daily distance that I'm able to cover has been drastically reduced. When you stop, you think you're alone. That is until a shepherd quietly appears from nowhere with his goats. Having now crossed over the Atlas Mountains, I'm cycling south with the mountains on my right and the Sahara Desert to my left. One of my hosts, an enthusiastic Berber, took me on a tour of the oasis and the historic ruins. The oasis is amazingly tranquil. Roses are grown for perfume, as well as apricots, grapes, figs, dates, oranges, wheat, and walnut.
Thank you.
Soon we'll be crossing back over the Atlas Mountains, which will take about 3 days. The first day into the mountains and heading towards Marrakesh, the wind was gale force with gusts of 40 kilometers per hour. After a meager 30 kilometers covered, it was time to quit. The second day not much better, but at least managed to get in some mileage before the wind picked up again. In a guest house tonight and it's freezing cold. Tomorrow I should make it over the summit and we'll head towards Marrakesh.